Welcome to Oracle University's student experience. Oracle University offers over 200 courses in all of Oracle's products, including Oracle 10G, Application Server 10G, eBusiness Suite, and development tools. Several hundred thousand students visit us in 70 countries worldwide and learn in 10 different languages. This video showcases the OU experience from the eyes of our students. You will see everything our students see when attending an Oracle course. Today's video showcases instructor-led training on Oracle Database 10G administration, taking place in Redwood Shores, California, which is also the location of Oracle headquarters. This is a real class with students from several companies, including Penn State University, the Internal Revenue Service, and Siebel Systems. The video depicts the student experience offered all over the world and provides an eye into the quality of training Oracle provides to its customer.
Good morning. All right, I promise that's as cheesy as I get. My name is Jay Norton, as it's written up here on the board. I'm an instructor based here in the Bay Area, so I'm home this week. Very happy to be home. Where am I? Next week I'm going to New York, or actually Jersey. So good to be home this week. Great weather. I know most of you are from the area as well. We're here for the 10G Workshop 1 class, the first of the 10G curriculum, 10G database curriculum, that is. 5-day class, good information in it, a lot of information. Hopefully get a great foundation on becoming a 10G DBA. As I mentioned, my name is Jay Norton. I've been teaching for Oracle University for about 3.5 years now. Before that, I was in Oracle Support Services, where I supported the database on NT and NetWare platforms, and got a great opportunity to learn kind of how the database really works.
The best way to learn Oracle is from Oracle itself. Our instructors are fully certified on Oracle technology and consistently deliver the highest quality training worldwide. Our content is written by the same teams that build our products. It's accurate, up to date, and is designed for the student to have a quality learning experience.
Well, on Monday morning, first day of class, we as instructors, we come into the Ed Center and everything's supposed to be set up for us. As an instructor, all I need to do is download the presentation slides, the PowerPoint slides, on the instructor machine and verify things are set up correctly. My instructor work area that I have in the classroom is really just consists of a PC with, you know, regular PC, keyboard, mouse, screen, and a desk area for me to set down notes or papers or whatever I need to. You know, most of the work is done walking around, talking with students. In the education room at the Oracle Ed Centers, we can, as instructors, broadcast our screen, what we're doing up there at the instructor work area. We can broadcast that to the students' machine, so on their screen sitting right in front of them, they can not only see the presentation slides that we are delivering as we discuss the chapter, but if we need to add to that by demonstrating some of the technology, we can actually do that on the machine at the instructor work area, and they see that as well. So they can, it's as if they were sitting at the same computer as the instructor. Our class structure varies from course to course. Most of the classes include a lecture time where we're going through the material that's in the curriculum. And then at the end of most chapters, not all, but most chapters, there's a hands-on opportunity for the students to actually implement and practice what the instructor just talked about, be it through installing software, configuring it, using it, breaking it, and fixing it again. It depends on the course, but a definite hands-on environment exists for the students to practice what they've learned. When the students come in on the first day of class, they're usually either handed out or they're sitting on a back table, the student kit. The student kit includes a one or possibly multiple manuals, volumes we call them, depending on the length of the course, there may be multiple. It includes a notebook for them to use just to take notes in, and a tent card, a name tent, so they can write their name so the instructor can easily see the person's name, who it is.
I'm Bob Williams, and I work for the Internal Revenue Service, the Department of the Treasury.
My name is Kirk Hill. I work for the National Alliance for Insurance Education and Research.
I work for Internal Revenue Service, and my name is Mike Coy.
I was asked to find instructions for Oracle Database Administration and Oracle Application Server.
I came to this Oracle University so I could learn to be Oracle DBA to get Oracle certified. I wanted to go ahead and learn from the source, so that's why I came to the Belmont, California campus.
IRS is in a transitional period where we're moving from Informix to Oracle, not only on our mainframe servers, but also on our web farm servers.
Several years ago, I started my Oracle training with Oracle 9i database and Oracle 9i application server. Several of their courses that included obviously application server. We did also the internet directory and some of the security management.
Right now we run Oracle on 8i and we need to upgrade, so somebody in the company had to come, and I seem to be the one that can show the other people how to do what needs to be done, and I have a little bit probably a higher learning curve than some of the other guys, so it'll help us improve as basically to upgrade our Oracle database, make sure we have the proper security in place to do the we also need to have good backup and recovery systems in place.
I've got 60 web farm servers that I'm currently responsible for, in addition to about 14 different other servers that are all Oracle database flavors.
My previous courses I've had good experiences with. This last month that I started the 10G application server as well. And I've had good experiences. I've traveled to Orlando. I've had them in Orlando, Phoenix, and then here in California. And all of them have been good experiences.
I've been in the IT business now for about 10 years. I'm a systems administrator. I'm also Microsoft certified. So it gives me a chance to kind of compare the courses that Oracle gives and Microsoft gives to see which I really like best.
IRS before sent us to classes that were vendor-led, that, you know, they said they could teach this or that, but actually it's more from the horse's mouth, so to speak. Oracle has provided me with a very good background on all the different classes that I have taken.
Sometime during the week, instructors show the students. We show them how they can get additional information, learning resources, once they've left the classroom that kind of edify what they've already learned. And there's a couple big resources we give them. First of all, we give them at the present time 45 days free access to the Oracle Online Library. In addition to that, the students have the opportunity to purchase CDs, CD-ROMs that have self-paced training on them. At the end of the course, the students are requested to fill out a evaluation to evaluate not just the instructor, but also the course itself, the curriculum, the education center. The evaluations are then, you know, tabulated immediately through some internal systems. We're in the 95% range as far as customer satisfaction goes, so we're really proud of that. On the last day of class, the students will receive a certificate of completion that looks something like this. The instructor signs it and dates it, and we hand it off to the students. And most students are very appreciative of this certificate. It doesn't say that they're certified, but does show that they were able to work through the class and get through the exercises.